Moldbusters, and in today's episode of What's in Our Toolbox, we're going to be looking at air sampling. Now, indoor air quality sampling is one of the most important tools in our toolbox. It helps us to confirm or deny the presence of mold, and it also helps us to prove that mold remediation was successful. There are many, many different ways to test the indoor air quality of a home or office. Today, there are many different companies that are offering indoor air quality testing, and as a result, there are a variety of machines and methods used to do so. Moldbusters primarily uses these types of air sampling pumps. As you can see, they are small, portable, and they are very reliable. Now, these types of air sampling pumps need to be properly calibrated beforehand in order to capture the proper amount of air. We typically calibrate these machines to capture 75 liters of air. That can take anywhere between 5 and 6 minutes. Essentially, these devices are impressive air vacuums that capture solid airborne particles. We also use these air cassettes in order to collect the air sample. Essentially, at the center of this cassette, there is an adhesive glass slide. Now, when we put this cassette onto the machine, and this impressive little air vacuum absorbs all of the solid airborne particles, those particles remain stuck to that adhesive glass slide. We then take the cassette, we send it off to the laboratory where they remove the slide, put it under a microscope, and analyze every single particle that was found. The indoor air quality sampling procedure always begins with a phone call. We receive a concerned call from a client who is looking to test the indoor air quality of their home or office. They usually have a concern brought on by allergic reactions, symptoms of illness, or a smell that they cannot identify. Step two is when our technician arrives. Our qualified technician assesses the indoor situation and decides where the machine is going to get put. Step three is that we calibrate and deploy the air quality machine. As we'll discuss later on in the video, it is important to test the outside air as well. Step four is that we take those air cassettes and we send them to the laboratory for analysis. We always use a certified and accredited laboratory that specializes in microbial analysis. Step five is that we receive the results from the laboratory, we prepare a detailed report, and we follow up with the client. Did you know that the first indoor air quality test as we know it was conducted in the 1930s? That's right. William Wells, a Harvard engineer, was hired to investigate the potential for respiratory infections from aerosols of stagnant water used to keep down dust in New England textile mills. Wells sampled the air with a centrifuge that he created himself, where he was able to recover and analyze captured bacteria. This completely revolutionized the field as we know it. Now, with indoor air quality testing, we can sample and look for just about any airborne particle. From dust to pollen to spores to asbestos fibers, there is very little that indoor air quality tests aren't able to understand. Moldbusters primarily searches for mold spores when conducting our indoor air quality services. We are able to confirm or deny the presence of mold. We are able to know the species of spores found. We are able to know the concentration levels of those spores, and we are able to provide an accurate remediation prescription for the problems found. When it comes to the levels of mold spores, it's important to note that Health Canada has no recommended threshold levels for indoor mold conditions. Essentially, the indoor air quality of a premises must be better than the outdoor air quality of a premises. This is why when conducting an indoor air quality test that we must do an outdoor air quality sample as well. It helps to establish a particulate baseline where we will compare those indoor results to. This can be very helpful for a number of different situations, including going to court. And there you have it. You've just learned about one of the tools in our mold removal toolbox. Stay tuned next week for the other video. Don't forget to visit our website at www.busmold.com. Also, like and follow us on Facebook and Twitter to receive daily tips and articles. Thank you very much.